Bed. Love.
Bed.
Bed.
Love.
Beyond.
Beyond.
Bed, love, beyond.
Bed, love, beyond.
Hey, what is going on, everybody? Welcome to Bed, Love, Beyond, the podcast for the hopeful and the hater in us to discuss sex, love, and whatever's clever with like-minded people like you who are also in limbo in love.
Like us.
Like us, yes. All right, what's going on? My name is Martini, the co-host of this podcast, and the other co-host is
Jennifer. I feel weird saying my name every week.
Well, I'm not gonna say it for you. Like, you know, like,
anyway.
You gotta introduce yourself.
I had
yourself.
A joke there, but I'm not going to go there. Anyway, go
hey,
ahead.
All right, I just got that. All right, so this is part two of our explain yourself series, I guess. I mean, it's not really a series, it's just a part two. And so part one was about, you know, I don't know what I want out of life, and that was very interesting for the both of us. If you want to listen to it again, please listen to it. You know, we were just trying to decide, you know, where we are in our
life.
Lives, yeah, and what to do, what's going on, and
what the next step is.
Yeah, what the next step is. It's pretty crazy. And but for this episode, we're going to be talking about X or next. So
next.
Meaning about, like, should we keep in contact with our exes, or should we, you know, go on to the next one? So yeah, that's what we're going to be talking about in this episode. But first, we're going to talk about the Daily Dish and what is going on in our lives. So, Jennifer, I pass it to you. What has been going on in your life? What's up? What's going on?
Creepers on OkCupid.
Okay.
One guy was, like, in a hospital bed in this picture. It was really weird, and I felt really bad. But, like, the bleeding heart in me, like, reached out to him, and now he's, like, just typing back. And I was like, okay. One guy kept calling. I told him, I don't think this was work because I don't want a boyfriend.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, well, why were you on OkCupid? I'm like, that is a very good question.
Yeah, that is.
I can't be
good
like,
question.
Oh, it was for research for the podcast.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so it's just a bunch of weirdos. Other than that, I mean, I just work and ward off the weirdos.
Ward off the
weirdos.
There
was deep conversation guy, but, like, he goes out salsa dancing every weekend. And I'm like, why can't you find a girl? Like, you live in the city and you salsa dance every weekend and go to these socials. And you're like, he's like another one of those, like, life coaches. They find me, the life coaches. But I'm just like, eh. But I haven't met him yet. I don't know that I'm going to.
Right. Well, I mean, just because the city is vast, that's the hindrance of the city. It's too big. So, like, a lot of people can't find, like, love.
It's a social. You're going there to be social.
Yeah, but maybe you strike his fancy and not these other chicks.
I haven't heard from him in 2 days. I doubt that. But moving on. How things been on your end?
Man, just a lot of reflection. You know, the if anybody who keeps following the podcast, you know, I'm an overthinker and I reflect a lot. So, you know, there has been certain things that have been going on in my life that I need to reflect on. And just the main thing is about change. And, well, what I am and who I am as a person and momentum forward for change. And we're definitely going to discuss about that later in the podcast. It's going to be interesting. I think you'll be pleasantly surprised.
I still think you should let me write your OkCupid profile.
I don't know if I'm going to go on OkCupid because, just like you, you know, like, you don't know why you're on there, but you're on there. So I don't know what to do with myself as well.
I'm going to deactivate my profile anyway.
I don't know. Like, I kind of do want to go on there to see what's out there, but I don't know if I'm ready for what's out there.
I want you to go on so I can see what the competition looks like. Sorry.
What? I don't get what that
I'm
means.
I'm partially kidding. I just want to, like, everyone's always like, oh, yo, the girls are mad crazy on here. But all guys say that.
Oh, like that.
But, like, I wanted to know, like, from, like, someone who I'm, like, close to, their perspective, like, are the girls really that crazy?
Well, they, well, I shouldn't say expect. They, a lot of them write the same things. Like, they want the same things. So I don't know, depending on who you are, it might be annoying that you keep seeing the same thing, or annoying that that same thing you can't provide for them. So it dwindles your pool. So I don't know. It's interesting.
More about that at a later time.
Yeah. But okay, so the first segment of the podcast is the exes. So I'm going to ask, should we still keep in touch with our exes? To what capacity? What are the pros and cons? Can we move on if they are in our lives? What do you think?
You're asking the wrong person. Didn't we have this discussion last week? That
did we?
The last podcast that I am, like, the advocate for, like, staying friends with your ex. See, this is the problem. I don't remember what we talked about on the podcast and, like, just randomly. But I am an advocate for staying. Well, this is the thing. It depends on what they did to you.
Yes.
Like, if they were psycho, like the restraining order boy.
Yes.
No. You don't keep in contact with those people.
Right.
But, like, if it was just, like, we dated, we decided we wanted different things, and we know we're not going to be, like, a good match in the future, then I don't see what the harm is. But if it's just, like, you know, we dated and, like, you slept with my best friend, then you can go kick fucking rocks. We're not doing it. It's all about circumstance, Martini. All about circumstance.
No, it's true. I definitely, yeah.
And tolerance.
Yeah.
Like, what you can tolerate. Like, can you tolerate meeting the new boo?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yep. Because, yeah, it really all depends. I know through my past experience. Well, I mean, you guys know, it hasn't been a secret, you know, with my ex-fiance and stuff like that. I haven't been very vocal in keeping in touch with her. Like, I don't really contact her at all. Like, if she, like, I'm not opposed to really contacting her, but I just don't. She, like, if she wants to speak to me, like, she totally can, but obviously she doesn't because she has a new boo in her life. So that's her new priority. And you know what? I'm fine with that because I do not want to know what's going on in their lives, even though, like, I always get
updates on Facebook.
You know, that's the worst. That I don't, you know, have anything to do with, you know, like, because we still have mutual friends. So let's say a mutual friend, like, likes her picture. Bam, it comes up comes up on my timeline. I'm like, damn it. Yeah. I didn't need to see that. You know, so.
As where I went to, like, brunch with my ex and his new girlfriend the other day.
Yeah. So.
And I was totally cool with it.
Yeah.
I was just like, he's going to fuck her over too. But no. I had a long talk with him. I was like, yo, be good to her. She seems like a really good girl. Like,
right.
I don't have any hard feelings about what happened to us because I didn't give a shit at the end of the day. And, like, she seemed nice and he seemed happy with her and it was nice. I kind of appreciated that he wanted, like, my feedback on it. I think he wanted my feedback on it.
Right.
Unless he was, like, doing some, like, weird twisted thing where he was like, I want both these women in the same room.
Oh, hey. Well, I'm sure that probably, yeah.
It was Cheesecake Factory. It was, like, nothing was popping off in there and I was flirting with the waiters, though.
Oh, man.
That's my new thing. Yeah. I just want to see if I still got it. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
No, you're good. No, but yeah, it really all depends because some people really can't handle seeing their ex with, like, a new person, or even worse, have that ex come to you with that new person and say, like, oh my god, like, isn't he like the cat's meow? And you're like, no, F that guy. You know what I'm saying? You want me to compliment you on my replacement? Like, that's messed up.
Yeah, I think it depends on how much your heart was invested that you can, like, indulge in that kind of thing.
Yes, exactly. So. Yeah. So, of course, you know how we do. We look up articles, you know, to try to weed out any answers or anything like that. And I fell on one from Vogue.com, actually, and it was under, it wasn't necessarily yes or no, it was under maybe, maybe not, and the article was, it was called Breathless, Should You Be Friends With Your Ex? And I read the whole thing, but I just, like, paraphrased what I wanted to talk about, even though it looks really long right now, but it's good, it's really good, so I'm gonna read it right now, so. It says, unfortunately, our exes don't disappear from the earth after a breakup. They keep existing, seemingly for the sole purpose of appearing when you're horribly hungover, buying Advil and coconut water in your sweatpants, and then boom, there they are, still alive. I've never understood those couples who stay friends after a breakup. It just seems impossible to form something truly platonic with a person who I've been in love with, who knows exactly how to make me come, and who's seen me smell my underwear to check if they're clean.
Ew.
Many claim that being friends with your ex is the mature thing to do, but I always feel like those people are confusing maturity with masochism. Mm. But if you do choose to keep your ex in your life, it's important that the friendship is genuine, without ulterior motives. In my experience, when exes stay friends, there's usually another dynamic at play. For example, one partner secretly hopes to get back together or is feigning closeness to keep dibs on the other. Or you agree to spend time with your ex out of pity because they still like you and the attention feels good. Or you could be using the facade of friendship simply to hurt the other person, e.g. making them jealous by rubbing new romances in their face. We've all been to that awkward holiday party with an ex-couple. Isn't it great we've stayed friends? Where one ex is obviously enjoying parading around their new partner while the other slightly dies inside by the hors d'oeuvres. And lastly, a classic case is the type who keeps their exes around as a backup plan in case no one better comes along. Not only is this unfair to your ex, but this dynamic is probably holding you back as well. You might not realize it, but keeping your ex around as a friend after a breakup can keep you from moving on. You think you're being morally superior, when actually your ex is sucking up so much emotional bandwidth that you have zero energy left for Tinder. Moving on is hard, and the impulse to keep your ex in your life can be really strong. We all get it. And yeah, maybe you can have your ex back in your life in some capacity down the line, but you'd first need to give yourself a window to move on physically and emotionally. It's not weak or dramatic to stop following your ex on social media. It's strategic. If you don't, you'll just end up staring at your phone all day, waiting to find clues in each new Instagram they post. Mm-hmm. You might have to sacrifice some parties, restaurants, movie theaters, and even countries to avoid running into them for a while. But if you do end up in a place where you might run into your ex, be sure to look casually fabulous.
Damn right.
So, I mean, I...
Oh, that one part, like, really struck me. It says that you agree to spend time with your ex out of pity because they still like you and the attention feels good.
Mm-hmm.
I have never done that. Yes. But now in retrospect, I wonder if that was done to me.
Ooh. Okay.
Yeah. And when you said it, I was like, ouch. I don't like that.
Yeah, that's not good whatsoever.
No, I mean, that's a really shitty feeling, and I really wish people would be honest. But
I mean, it's so hard to be honest when you...
No, it's not.
No.
That's a whole other podcast.
When you get up to that point, calm down. when you get to that point, you know, everything is just like a whirlwind. So you don't know how to react and everything. So I totally understand that.
I mean, the whole strategic thing about taking them off Instagram and Facebook and stuff like that, social media, I kind of wish I would have done that with my last ex, just because in the beginning, like, he obviously doesn't do it anymore because I don't know if he cares or not, but irrelevant. That, like, he used to be like, oh, I saw you like this on Facebook, or I saw you like, I don't understand what your end game is, buddy. I was like, yeah, I did. He's like, is that in like reference to our relationship? And I'm like, of course it's in reference to our relationship. I'm not going to sit up on Facebook and be like, my heart is broken. But if I see a meme that says it, I'm like.
Right.
So like, no, my heart's just broken because, you know, they didn't put pepperoni on my pizza tonight.
What?
I don't know.
Oh, man.
Read the signs, buddy. Read the science.
Yeah, so I guess this person is really advocating not being friends, really, because it's pretty much a restraint from you from moving on, and I can totally see that, where it's hard, because yeah, you might fall into that trap of thinking, you know what, maybe if I, like, I don't know, not cuddle next to her or whatever, but like if I stay a little bit longer, maybe she'll see the error of her ways and then like we get back together and it'll be awesome. And like meanwhile she's like, yeah, so I'm going on a date tonight, so yeah. And you're like, what, a date? Does he look good? How does he look? You know, so like, you
take pictures.
Yeah. And it hurts, you know, like it really hurts. Notice that I'm speaking from experience. So
well, our friends over at MTV say that it is good to stay friends with your ex. They yes. agree with me. They know. Maybe because I'm that MTV generation when they actually played videos. They say 8 surprisingly awesome reasons to stay friends with your ex. The number one reason is no custody battle for mutual friends. After a breakup, it's common to question who gets to keep the friends. This puts a lot of pressure on your mutual ones. Staying friends with your ex assures that everybody that they won't be pulled into that position. Your circle is like a regular circle and there's no sides to choose. Number two, no one is the villain. That's not true. Basically, it just says that no one's going to be bitter or have resentment because, you know, it's high five. We're still friends. I think that depends, but we'll get back to that. Mm-hmm. Number three, you gain a friend who knows you better than most. Your friends might know you, but not the same way they would if they have dated you. Your ex can read you like no one else, and that's a rare, important quality to have in a friendship. They can tell you what you don't always want to hear, but sometimes need to hear, because dating basically trained you for that.
Yeah, and I do remember you, I believe, last podcast, you talking about that. That's kind of like, well, not the necessarily, I guess the reason why you've kept in contact with so many of your exes is right. because they know they've reached an upper echelon of understanding you and like and you know that you understanding them about like relationships, and you can go to them and talk to them and be like, yo, this guy and or whatever, what happened to this girl and all this
right,
stuff.
Right, like so. I remember when I was dating my ex, I would like call him. Well, I was dating my ex and I called the ex. I was like three exes before that.
Yeah.
You know, and I'd be like, I did this and he did this, and he would be like, yo, you need to chill out. He's like, I know you mm-hmm. and you're being extra right now. He's like, and think about what you're saying, and he's a man, and like he would give me the man's perspective that I wasn't necessarily always ready to hear.
Right.
But he'd be like, yo, call him and apologize. And you know, sometimes I was just being like irrational.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that doesn't happen. And I would. I'd be like, all right, let me think about this, and I would do. But back to number four. There's nothing left to fight about. You've already had all the fights, and the solutions to them were breaking up, I guess. I don't know. Number five, you both have endless amounts of joke ammunition. It'd probably be a really good person to play Taboo with, too. I'm just saying. I'm just saying. I mean, that's the person I play with.
Yeah, that's true.
Number six, there's less baggage to bring into your next relationship. Your track record with exes can tell a potential partner a lot about your romantic past. A history of bad breakups suggests that you might be the problem, but a history of healthy ones highlights positive qualities that you can bring to a relationship. Your personality, your passion, your ex's Netflix password. I don't want him giving out my password. Number seven, you can be happy for each other. I'm not there yet.
Yeah, I'm not there.
With some of them, I am. Like the guy who I went out with and met his girlfriend, I'm like happy for him.
Yeah.
If he does the right thing, I'm happy for him.
Yeah.
If he breaks that girl's heart, I'm gonna kick him in the penis.
Okay.
Yeah. Number eight. Subsequent breakups are less scary. At the very least, you learn it's okay to end something that's not working, because you won't always lose this person forever. A failed relationship doesn't have to be a waste of time. It could be a road less traveled to a successful friendship. I have to say, I've used those exact words mm-hmm. before.
Yeah.
I was dating this guy and I was trying to break up with him, and I told him, like, I've learned that if I'm in something that's not healthy and like not going in a positive direction, I need to leave it. And I think I need to leave this. Mm-hmm. That conversation didn't go the way that it was supposed to go.
Mm-hmm.
That's a whole nother story.
Yeah,
we broke up anyway.
Yeah,
and we are friends now. But I knew from the door like that wasn't a healthy thing, and my other relationships taught me that. So
yeah,
I don't know. It's like it's just another breakup. On to the next. maybe not. Who knows?
Right.
So MTV agrees with me.
Yeah. Those were good. That was a good list. I mean, It's totally your preference to.
Do you agree with MTV Martini?
I like those reasons. They're good reasons, but again, it depends on what happened in the relationship. And it depends on the people, because it's hard. Like, you know, like we're both going through it on an individual, you know, state. So it's extremely hard to see, to see that far ahead. Like, nah, I could definitely, like, you know, be friends with my ex.
I think it depends who it is.
Yeah, yeah, it definitely is. And also, I mean, we're not really gonna go into this, but we're definitely gonna leave this article on the website. But yeah, don't stalk your ex on Facebook.
Why are you looking at me like that? No, really.
No, I'm just am.
Oh yeah, like, really? You just are.
Yeah.
Yo, I'm getting like the illest like ice girl right now. Like,
no, I'm just saying, don't do it.
It's, what about it's Instagram? Is Instagram okay?
No, nothing. Just leave it alone.
Twitter,
man.
Twitter.
Just leave it alone. It's not good. It's not good whatsoever. It's
sometimes
just
they just
business.
Like want to know he's still breathing.
No, like it's fine. You know, like, don't stalk. I mean, if you want to know if he's breathing or not, text him. That's not stalking.
No.
Because you sent out the broadcast.
I don't think he wants that.
And then if he receives it, it's all good. But, like, don't do that. But before we get on to the next subject, pun intended, we still need to talk about what we talked about in the last closing minutes of the last podcast.
Oh yeah, spoiler alert.
Spoiler alert. Yeah, so in case, you know, you're just tuning in or whatever, you know, we created this website, you know, Bed, Love, and Beyond, you know, just talk about just relationships and things like that. And the creation of it kind of was because, yeah, we were just both, Jennifer and I were both like lost in love, and it was a culmination of us pretty much like dating, you know? So like, yeah. So like we used to date, and
how many years ago was it?
7 years. It was seven years
ago.
He was
like, let me give you the date.
Yeah. Well, no, we shouldn't do that. Okay. Even though I know it.
We know.
Yeah. Yeah. We dated 7 years ago, and
for how long?
4.5 months.
Okay.
And we broke up.
Yeah, we did.
And then I didn't speak to her for 7 years. Because I was traumatized, because I'm sensitive, guys.
You know? I was not the nicest person. I think I met you on OkCupid.
Yeah.
And you were like the nicest guy. I had always said, I met this really nice guy at OkCupid once, but he hates me now. I met you on OkCupid. The first time I met you, I invited you to my house.
Yes.
Not like that. Not like, hey,
come
on over.
No. She, yeah. Because, listen, I have no game. So, like, you know, I just did my best. And, you know, she's like, oh, like, come over to the house. And I'm like, oh, okay, whatever. Like, all
right,
fine.
I told you I was having a party, though, right?
Yeah, no. You were telling me. Yeah. Oh. You wasn't
hoeing it out. Like, come on over.
No, you definitely said that because there was a fight going on because she's into a UFC. And I was like, okay, but like to me, I was thinking that's weird because it's so unconventional. Because I'm like, you know, oh, we're supposed to.
You didn't know I was an unconventional gal.
Well, no, not back then. Now I know all too well.
Okay, moving on. So I invited you over to the house for the fight.
Yeah.
And then a rock band party broke out.
Yeah.
That was cool.
Yeah. Yeah, that was pretty.
But it was weird because there was like.
There was like 1,000 people.
A thousand people there.
I'm meeting everybody for the first time. I'm meeting her and all her friends, all her
guys
closest
and
friends,
girls.
Guys and girls, for the first time. So I'm already going crazy because like, oh my god, a girl might like me. This is awesome, you know. And like, I got a phone number. I'm like, oh my god, a girl's phone number. Yippee, you know. And then
so
I'm
was
like,
was that bad 7 years ago?
Yeah.
You're thirsty.
Yeah.
A little bit.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I adore you. Go ahead.
And then I'm like, what? I'm meeting her and all her friends. Oh yeah, no pressure, you know. So it's so funny too because like
there were some grown and sexy folk there too.
There was what?
Some grown and sexy folk there too.
Well, yeah.
I remember you said something to me. Was it you who said it? I think so.
What?
You were like, you were just like, there was like all these like, I don't remember. It may not have been you. Never mind. Just that there was like some of my male friends are very nice looking.
Right.
And there was just, they were just kind of all standing around. It was very. Like, now that I look at the pictures, I'm like, God, that must have been uncomfortable.
Oh, yeah. Well, I was gonna bring that up. I mean, we're not gonna like obviously like show you pictures, but I'll just describe them for you. Okay. Everybody's having a good time, and you see me in the background slouching in a chair, just like, what the F am I doing here? You know, because like I felt like I didn't belong, or like I'm not gonna get to know her, or like, yeah, just like she said, like you see all these freaking like Adonises like parading around the room, and I'm like, womp womp. You know what I mean? Like,
I know as a guy that must be kind of intimidating, like, oh, what's their story? Or
of course, and they're just like, what the hell, you know? I'm like,
I was not intimate with anyone in that room,
so oh, okay,
now or ever.
That's good. That's good to know, I guess. But yeah, so it's just weird. But yeah, but I don't want to say we had a falling out, but it was a bad. It was a bad breakup. I guess
I went back to my ex.
Yes. Yeah. She went back to her ex, whatever. And I completely understood the reasonings, you know. But like, obviously, I still felt hurt because I was, you know, catching feelings for her. So because of what happened, you know, I was like, yo,
F girls,
I'm not gonna stay around for what? Like, she is getting what she wanted because she went for it, and that's it. Oh, also that relationship also made me hate Adele as well. Because that was like her soundtrack. That was like Jen's soundtrack. Like every time she wanted me to understand like why she did what she did, she would like give me an Adele track, and I'm like, yo, F this chick, yo. It's like I hate Adele.
But yeah.
The first album. So
Chasing Pavement still gets to me.
Oh my god. It does get to me too. Like,
I did feel really bad, and I did try to like, you know, play nice with you. Yes. But yeah. I mean,
and she did try to reach out, but I was not,
like, various times.
Yeah, various times throughout the years, mind you.
Yeah,
but I was not having it
because you still had some mutual friends.
Yes.
That I have.
Yes.
And I would see them, when I'd see them, they'd be like, oh, I saw Teeny, and I'm like, oh, how's he doing? And like, he has a girlfriend. I'm like, that's great. I saw you and your girlfriend once on the parkway too. That was funny.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, you guys were driving back up to New York State, and I was going to Palisade Center, and I was like, oh, should I honk? And then I was like, nah, he probably fucking run me off the road. I'm like, damn.
Oh, man, that's funny.
But yeah, and like, I would like try to reach out to Martini, and a lot of times I'd get like an email back like, what, Jennifer? What do you want?
Yeah, because I was just really pissed, because I was like, why? Like, what? Like, why do you, what do you want from me? Because, you know, because now that we, you know, in future tense, now that we know that, like, she likes to keep in contact with her exes because she, you know, she can repurpose them as friends, because those are very good friends to have, because those are rare friends to have. But me, I didn't know that. I'm like, what do you want? Like, you got your dude. Leave me alone.
And that was grand opening, grand closing, but that's just at the point.
What?
I said that was grand opening, grand closing.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah. That relationship that she left me for, like, it ended pretty quick. But I was just like, I really didn't care, because, like, I was still, like, so heated, and I just had, like, this 7-year, like, grudge, like, against mm-hmm. her, you know? And then, like,
one faithful day.
Yeah, one faithful day, you know? Well, no, this is the funny thing. Like, my ex-fiance, while I was going out with her, she was like, she always knew of Jennifer, but never, like, they never met or whatever. Well, they kind of did, but not really.
You're like, I saw you at a comedy club. What were you doing in my city? What? I'm like, bitch, I run Rockland.
Jeez. but it was pretty funny.
In 98.
My ex-fiance was like, look, you have this, like, dark cloud over your head, and you can't move forward. And that's going to hurt you, like in the future. Like, you really need to just let go of that. Because I hold grudges. I don't, like, I'm mad nice to people and stuff like that. So, like, when people do bad things to me or whatever, like, I'm like, F you. I didn't do anything to you. So, it's like, so I just had this, like, yeah, this dark cloud. And I was like, no, like, I'm not going to, like, forgive her or whatever, blah, blah. She knew what she did. And she's like, yeah, but, you know, you have to, like, let that go. So I was like, rrr. So I was like, fine. So, like, yeah, like, one day I texted her. No, not text. Well, I wrote her, like, this long-ass email suggesting that we should meet, you know, and like bury the hatchet. Just mm-hmm. just bury the hatchet. And like you wrote back and you're like, yeah, like let's do it. So we met up at a restaurant and like we just like hashed it out, like pretty much everything.
Yeah, you were like, but you were like hella angry. Like the moment I walked up to you, you were still like,
yo, because I haven't seen you in like 7 years. So it's like all this anger was
and
like,
I'm like, hey, Zini. And you're like, hey, what's up?
Because I indirected, like, without my volition. Yeah, it was like, it automatically was like, yo, I needed you to know why
Martini,
I was so angry.
I got
angry.
The emails over the years. I knew. I knew.
I
was like, yo, this is fire. Yeah. And I let other people read them because I was like, yo, check this out. Yeah. They're like, he fucking hates you, dude. I was like, I know. They're like, as he should. I was like, damn it. Everyone was like Team Teeny anyway. So they're just like, yo, you deserve that.
Yeah, so it was so real. So
it was shady. It was very juvenile of me the way I went about it. Mm-hmm. And as an adult, I can say that.
Yeah. So we talked it over and then like even then because she was like, all right, so like, you know, while like we were like leaving, she was like, okay, so like we exchanged numbers and like, so like, what's up, like, do you want to be like friends? I was like, I'll think about it.
Yeah, you
were- yo. I'm just thinking about it now.
You're like mad super villain about
I know it. I was like so harsh. I was like, I'll think about it. Fucking bitch. You know, just like, I was, because I was so,
yo, you notice that Martini like never curses on the podcast, but in reference to me, she just like straight up was like, fucking bitch. Like, damn, Teeny.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Cold hearted. Don't be sorry. That's your feelings, man. We're good.
I like censoring myself, but no, but like that's how I felt. And I was just like, yo. But then like, you know, it was just like chipping away, because it finally cracked, like the, you know, like the darkness like finally cracked, so it was like chipping away off of me. So like every so often, you know, I probably like text her like, hey, what are you doing? And you're like, hey, what's going on? I'm doing this, blah, blah, blah. That's swell. You know, whatever. And then weeks pass by, and then it was like, oh, all right. And then, you know, we were cool. And
they're
then,
like, oh, do you watch Married at First Sight? Do you watch this?
Like, yeah. Oh, and I was like, what the hell? I was like, yo, like, yeah, it was so weird because like we were like matching up, or like what the, like
we're like the same people in a specific way, like, yeah, it's weird.
It's extremely weird. And I'm like, yo, how did she freaking know to watch that? Because like I watch that, or like she'll like reference something and I'm like, what the, I referenced that too. It was uncanny. It was really weird.
But here we are,
yeah, and then
podcasting it up.
Yeah, we just like became like really cool again, and like, yo, that's like freaking like my dog, man. You know, like, she's awesome.
That was weird.
All right, yeah, that was like Randy, what? Randy Jackson?
Randy Jackson.
Sorry. That's my boo. That's my girl. You know, so.
I would have preferred like a more DMX like version of that. Exactly.
Yo, she's my dog. Not mean.
Exactly. That was that.
Yeah, so. Yeah, so yeah, we're mad cool. But like, there's one thing that you had to, that I want to know, that you told everybody out there in
podcast land,
that one of your all-time favorite
dates
was our first date. Even though our first date was, well, I thought was the party.
That was no date, Martini. That was just to see if I don't want to take my time to go out with you.
Okay. So.
And I was like, he's cool, I'll go.
So you're gonna have to.
So
remind
we
me.
Went to lunch, I think.
Okay.
At the mall.
Okay.
Mine
or yours?
Middle in the parkway, Prebs Park.
Okay.
And I don't know what we ate. I don't remember stuff like that.
Okay.
What restaurants there? Anything? Ruby Tuesdays? No. I don't know. We went somewhere. I don't know where we ate. That's really interesting. Or maybe we ate somewhere and then went there.
Okay.
And we walked around and I told you that I got a Wii. And we went to like the Suncoast video or whatever was there.
Yeah.
Throwback. And yeah. We were talking about that horrible dinosaur movie with the shaky cam.
Yo.
Anyway, this is not what that podcast is about. It's not about movies.
All right, this is what she's talking about. It's not a dinosaur movie. This is what she's talking about. She's talking about Cloverfield. And I love that movie. That movie is so good. If you did not see Cloverfield, watch it. Okay.
It's I was gonna vomit. Anyway, it was like a dinosaur tail.
You made it sound like it's like the Land Before Time. No.
Well, we talked about that.
Yeah.
And then we talked about the weed, and we talked about the stuff we like and the kind of music we like, and we walked around and we got to know each other, and that was nice. Like, you actually asked me questions,
yeah,
and like cared. You might have been one of those people that asked me about my eye contact issues too, but I don't remember at this moment. I feel like that was a conversation. But then when I got home, I got a gift request or a gift receiving thing from you on the Wii.
Yeah,
you sent me, and I was telling you about how I got the Wii and there was not really any games that like I was really super into.
Yeah.
And you sent me the original Mario Brothers.
Right.
For the Wii.
Yeah.
Like via, like you can send people stuff on the
Wii. I forget what it was called. By the way, I'm a big Nintendo fan. So like that's why I was like, oh wow, she's got a Wii. So like, and she really didn't like know too much about it. So I was like, oh, I'll freaking teach you about it. Like, not a problem. So like, yeah, I bought the game and then you can like gift it and send it to people on your friends list. So that's what I did.
Right. So then I got like Martini sent you a gift and I opened it up and I was like, oh my God, it said I had a great date, something, something.
Yeah.
And then you're like, whatever. And then I was like, oh my God, that's the nicest thing anyone's ever done. It was thoughtful.
Mm-hmm.
You did a lot of thoughtful things. But as a first impression.
Yeah.
And especially somebody who like loves electronics.
Mm-hmm.
Like that beat a fucking rose any day. So it was cool. And if like I had to like take a survey somewhere, this is like best date ever, that would have to be it.
Nice.
Because we talked and we walked around and like you actually cared and listened about what I wanted. And then, you know, instead of like, you know, the epic kiss goodbye, you're like, I'll send her a game.
Yeah, or like, yo, let's go back to your spot.
Right.
Not me. Let me watch your TV. You know, so, yeah. Okay.
So there was that, yeah.
Cool. Awesome. Yay, I got ranked best date ever. That's awesome. Woohoo.
I'll print out your award later.
my what is it, superlative?
Yeah.
So, in case anybody's wondering, because like you're like, oh my God, they got reacquainted. They're so cute. Oh my God, blah blah blah. So why? I don't get it. How come they're not together? And why am I making you talk in this voice? Because like, I don't know if anybody actually talks like that. But
that's Martini's voice for like everything that
is
sarcastic.
So, not gonna lie. I mean, because you know, when we got reacquainted, you know, after like we got past like the BS and stuff like that, you know, we started to like see things maybe like, oh, maybe, you know, like, you know, will they or won't they, you know, kind of like the Rachel and Ross thing. And we're like, you know what, this not to say that this is weird, but it was just like, you know what, we should just be this because like we really like gel together as like, you know, cool people. And just like she said in the article, and just like how the article said it itself, that like, you know, we have a different friendship than other people other people would have. You know, like we're very close, you know, we're cool, you know, like I even one time made up her OkCupid profile could go find like, you know, hot dudes and stuff like that. You know, because like I'm a writer, so like I am good with words. So I was like, yeah, I'll help you out. So yeah, we just have this like great bond, and you know, we just want to like keep it that way and not like muck anything up, you know what I'm saying? So with that, we, you know, move on to the next subject, which is talking about, you know, trying to find that next person. Because, you know, all right, so let's say we decided, you know, the X isn't going to be good. Nah, we're done with that. Let's see what's up with this new person. But first, we have to know, are you even ready to be in a relationship? So that's a big question, for, you know, before you start going on to a next person. And I know, Jennifer, you said before, like, you know, you're on OkCupid. And that person that, you know, that you didn't like, was like, if you don't want to have a boyfriend, why are you on OkCupid? And you're
it's
like,
it's not that I don't want to have a boyfriend. Question.
So it's like,
it's just that I don't want to have to like work too hard at it. And I know that sounds super shitty.
Yeah.
But like, I think this time I wanted to try to come somewhat easy.
Yeah.
And I'm being a lazy dater, maybe.
Okay.
And I don't know. I guess I just don't have time for like that whole getting to know you thing. That's why I like the Mr. Conversation guy. Mm-hmm. Like he just pulls conversation out of me. It's amazing. But at the end of the day, I'm like, we're not going to talk like this forever. This is like too philosophical. He'd be like, why do you like eggs, honey? Is it because they're white and yellow and those are your favorite colors? Like, shut up. Like, eventually, I'm going to, like, just, like, flip the script on him or something. Yeah,
just give me to them scrambled.
Damn it. I know. Like, eventually, it's going to become a problem. And that's the problem. Like, I'm still kind of figuring out myself, like, figuring out my flaws, figuring out, like, where I went wrong in my last relationship, how to fix it with the next person.
Yeah.
What not to do. Like, I know me being selfish about things that I want versus things that he wants is a big issue.
Yes.
And like already I was like thinking in my head, like, okay, so the guy who goes to these like salsa socials, right?
Yeah.
What if he's like, oh, do you want to come salsa dance with me on Saturday night? No, fuck, I don't want to go.
why don't you want to go?
I don't know how to dance salsa.
That's why that's there. Oh, it's not classes. It's people like that social, already know.
Like in,
oh,
okay. Like in Along Came Polly, how they just go to that place and they're all dancing salsa.
Okay, I got you.
And he's like, what? Yeah, it's probably like that. It's probably like a big sex pot. What? Not about that. I don't know. I blew it up in my head.
So, like, I don't know how that went through.
I don't know. Just roll with it, just please, for the sake of this conversation.
Okay, good.
I'm not going to sex pod salsa classes on Saturday. But if I want to be in a relationship with this man, which I don't necessarily know that I do, that might be something he likes to do, and that's going to be something that I have to debate about going to.
Right.
So those are things that I'm like mentally preparing myself for, and I think I need to find somebody who I'm like, what, you want to go to like the Lego factory and let's go. I don't even want to go with my god kids. I mean, I'll go with them,
right?
But you know what I'm saying, like I'm trying to get prepared for that, to be prepared to be somebody's partner, because I don't know that I always played that role the best way that I should have. So I'm preparing myself for that, and if I find somebody who I was gonna say who I deem worthy, which is basically the truth. So if I find somebody who I deem worthy of being my better half, then I'm gonna do it.
Yeah.
But you know, yo shorty, what's up? You're cute. Nice lips. What? Bye. No, I don't know. What do you say to that? Thanks. You know what these lips aren't doing? Talking to you. Peace, brother.
Oh.
And then we move on.
Gotti.
So yeah. So yes, I'm ready, and no, I'm not. It depends on like if you come correct or not.
That's good.
And yourself, sir?
That answer changes every day. It really does. You know what? No, I got it now.
Do you know?
Yeah, I do.
Oh, just now. if I wait 10 seconds, we'll change.
Maybe. But I want to be in a relationship. But I don't know if I'm ready.
Sometimes you just gotta take that leap of faith.
This is true. It's funny because like I wrote down this personal list because I didn't want to forget. Because I wanted to talk about it. Because
Martine is a perfectionist.
I wouldn't say all that. But yeah, so I wrote like my personal list of why I'm not ready is because I'm not financially stable or independent yet. Yeah, I know that's I know a lot of women are like, oh no, it's okay. It's like, no, it's like, it's really not, you know, like because I don't want to be like a pushover or whatever. And like, I don't want a sugar mama and stuff like that. I want to be financially stable and independent so I can contribute to whatever needs that you have. And I'm looking over this thing. It says not over my ex. It's not necessarily not over my ex. It's more so not over the situation. Because, like you know, I still get affected every time I see, like, something, like, new. Or, like, you know, the stories that I tell you, like, behind the scenes about things. And I'm just like, what? Like, she did this in this amount of time.
How do we get you over the situation?
That's a good question.
Can I push you over the situation?
Like, off a cliff? Like, I don't understand.
No,
like,
whatever it takes.
Like, I don't understand. I mean, no, I mean, that could be a good thing to talk about. And also, finally learning about myself and coming into my own, and I'm fearful of stopping the growth and making Miss Next a priority. Because sometimes, you know, when you're on your own, you know, you're on your own, you're doing your own thing, blah, blah, blah. But then, you know, when you introduce a woman into your life, she becomes priority. And sometimes other things lay up.
If you're a good man, she becomes priority. Sorry.
Oh, wow.
Opinion.
Yeah. No. But like, yeah. Okay, fine. If you're a good man, you know, she becomes priority. But then all the other things that you were working on fall on the wayside.
I feel like that's going to bite me in the ass somewhere down the line. But whatever. It's my opinion. In my humble opinion.
You know, so like, and not to say that it's necessarily the girl's fault, even though it kind of is, because she, you know, she is in your life. But a woman deserves and kind of wants attention. So like, I don't know if I'm ready to take that away, because I don't know if I'm ready to like give someone all that attention, because right now I need attention. And also, I wrote this thing on Facebook a couple of days ago, and I want to share it, because like I said at the top of the hour, that like, you know, it's a bunch of I'm realizing things about myself, and I need to do something about it. And I wrote this thing.
Do you journal?
I don't journal.
Get on it.
I used to, but I don't know.
It might help. You never know. No, maybe say it helps.
Right, but this is my thing. The title of it is "Never Fall in Love with Someone's Potential." And I wrote, this phrase was said about me, and I've always hated it. One, because after it was spoken, it changed the course of my life forever. And two, it hurts because deep down, I know it's the truth instead of hearsay. 4 years later, that phrase has saturated itself in every aspect in my life, and it still affects me till this very day. It is imperative that this needs to change. Too many opportunities have slipped through my fingers because of this potential trapped inside. Only a few have seen what I have to offer and have encouraged me to push further. Thank you, by the way. And now I plan to do so, because I've seriously had enough. It's time to stop being a potential prospect in life and start being a kinetic force to be reckoned with. I guess this is a long-winded New Year, New Me stamp, but I feel it's much deeper than a quip to be said once at the beginning of a calendar year. This needs to be an everyday in some way type deal. Anyway, that's my rant. Have a great day, everyone, and an even better year. Rock out with your socks out.
Did I read that?
I don't know. You didn't, because...
Did I like it?
No.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry.
That's fine.
I like it.
Thank you.
That's the first time I'm hearing it.
Oh, okay.
No, I'm serious. It is.
All right. I'm not saying
I'm being genuine.
Oh, thank you.
This is my genuine voice. I do. I really like it. That's really dope.
No, it's just because like with life and love and missed opportunities, like I feel that, I mean, I'm just going to say it. I feel that like I'm a failure and I need to rejigger that turn, and I need to like not feel that way anymore by moving forward and not getting in my own way.
I think the good part is that like a lot of people do feel like that. I don't think that you're alone in that boat in any means,
yeah,
by any means. But the good thing is that you recognize it, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
that you recognize like what the problems are, and you know kind of what way to go and fix it.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, and that's just something that you're working towards. A lot of people are like, I don't know, something's wrong, but I just can't figure out what. But you figured it out, so knowing is half the battle. G.I. Joe.
I was going to say that.
That was a meme, right? Like this week.
Yeah.
Now you know, and knowing is half the battle.
That's funny. Yeah, so moving on with this article from thedatingtruth.com, it talks about, you know, going, you know, next and seeing who that person is and what to do about that. And it says, the right relationship will find you once you create the right circumstances to invite it in your life. If you want to get into a relationship, I believe that you have to be ready for one. You have to clear the path between you and what you want and leave opportunity wide open for love to just walk right into your life. Most people can't let love in because they are living with blocks. Blocks such as negative beliefs, excuses, irrational fears, and poor social habits. Our ability to self-sabotage is so acute that even though we pass potential dates all the time, we repeatedly miss opportunities to connect with them because we aren't ready for the love we say we want. And that is me with T. And that's exactly what I was talking about. You know, I have all these blocks that are self-imposed. I mean, some of them, yes, are societal or whatever, but a lot of them are self-imposed. I don't know why they, I don't know where they come from. I guess it's because just of prior experience with like women and stuff like that. But yeah, that needs to stop.
I have to say that this year of being single, I feel like even though nobody might have seen it, that I've grown a lot and that I'm super focused. And part of me about getting into a new relationship is afraid that I'll lose that focus, like of what I want, of my goals that I want. Mm-hmm. And I'm not saying that. I was gonna say, I'm not saying my goals are more important than a relationship, mm-hmm. but right now, like, since it's all I have, they are. Mm-hmm. But I mean, I have grown, and I think that now that you know, like, where the ladder is, mm-hmm. you know, climbing it will be that much easier.
Right.
Bam with the metaphor.
Yeah.
So that's good. I mean, and I think that's the important thing about when you are single is not like taking the time to like get under somebody else necessarily as much as it's taking the time to make sure that you are okay with being by yourself. Like everyone says, like, if you can't stand your own company, that, you know, no one else is going to be able to stand your company.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like that's true. And there's a lot of times I sit here and I'm like, I don't want anyone here. Get out.
Right.
You know, and I'm like, I don't know that I want to entertain a dude right now.
Yeah.
And I don't know that I want to like go on a date right now. It's cold outside.
Yeah.
But like, you know, but that's good though, because in this time I've gotten used to being by myself, so that, not that I'll be by myself forever and I'll be okay with it, but like that I don't need you, not you particularly.
No.
I,
yeah.
I don't need like the man.
Yeah.
I just want him.
Yeah.
Maybe. We'll see.
Right. So with the question, you know, asked before, are we even ready for a relationship? You know, we always got to look at both sides. So I found an article that says, no, we're not ready for one, and one that says yes. So with the no, I'm going to read the six signs showing that you are not ready for a relationship. And this is from relrules.com, short for relationship rules. So number six is you are too possessive.
Nope. Next.
So no, what? What does that mean?
No, I'm not possessive.
I wasn't necessarily.
Oh, no. I'm doing a personal checklist over here. Sorry.
Okay.
I'm doing some self-evaluation.
Number five, you are too busy.
Shut up, Martini.
Got him.
I'll make time for the right person.
Oh, okay.
That's what they all say.
Good save.
Yeah, I know, right?
Your friends are your priority. That's number four.
Yes, maybe sometimes.
Number three, for the list of six signs showing you're not ready for a relationship. Number three is complaining attitude.
Nope. Over that.
Number two is you are not yet over your ex.
Nope. Over that.
And the number one sign showing you are not ready for a relationship is you have trust issues.
Nah, I'm good.
Wow. So look at that. Maybe you are ready for a relationship.
Maybe.
That was great. She's like, nah, I don't know. All right, so
do you have trust issues, Martini?
Do I have trust issues?
Yeah, I've never asked you that.
I don't know. Do I have trust issues?
I mean, after me, I would have. No offense to me.
You know,
not that I cheated on Martini. Let's just get that out.
Oh,
there.
That's true too. Yeah, no, she never did.
I did not cheat.
No, she didn't. No,
I made a choice.
Yes. Well, I kind of made it for you.
Okay. Again, keep going.
Our
time is running near.
Trust issues. I don't know. I don't know either way, to tell you the truth. I don't know. Like, you hit me with a pretty crazy question.
Okay, so how about you think about that for next week?
Yeah, I will.
Good. Thank you.
I will. So the flip side is like, yes, you are ready for a relationship. And there's 10 ways, but I'm not going to read all of them. I'm just going to read this one that I really liked. And it said, more important than some sort of checklist, though, is somebody else can't ever tell you how you feel inside. I believe when we reach the right phase in life or come across the right person, we will know we are ready to leave the single life behind and build a life alongside them. But until that person comes along, it's important to work on yourself and define our own happiness, which we can share with them. When you are ready, you will know.
I think that's a song.
I don't know.
It's churchy. Yeah. Mm. So, I don't know.
Yeah. Oh, there's another article too. Well, it's the same. It's by the same company. Well, same company, the same website. The Dating Truth, and it was they had their own like 7 signs for, you know, being ready for a relationship, and I like this one too, and I like it because it kind of stings for me because it almost seems like it's talking to me, but it says you take full responsibility for your love life. Having a relationship is a choice that you can make. You have the power to create the dating life that you want, but first you have to take action and do it. We tend to think, I can't, or I want a relationship, but I can't find one, or I can't make others date me. I have nothing against a reasonable objection, but the list of things you can't do is short compared to all the things that you could be doing for your love life. You know you're ready for a relationship when you can take full responsibility for being single. You don't make excuses or blame society or the numbers. You accept that you have some power over your dating experience and you exercise every bit of that power. You do something every day that will positively impact your love life and you speak optimistically about finding love.
Cautiously optimistic. Side note, MySpace name. Go ahead.
You're ready for a relationship when you are physically willing to do whatever it takes to have one.
Damn, I think I kind of fit that bill.
I think that's sound advice.
Well then. So, Martini, I see here on the agenda.
Yes.
The and.
Yes.
And I'm nervous.
There's this website that I fell on. And it's theand.us. I want everybody to pause this right now and go to that website. Just jot it down. Damn.
Or open up a new tab.
Okay, yeah, that's true. Yeah, keep listening because we have nice soothing voices. But open up a tab and go to that, okay? www.theand.us. And it's a website about relationships. All types of relationships. Relationships like gay, straight, relationships with, mother, you know, daughter, like mother, daughter, father, friends. Son, best friends, brothers, sisters, all that stuff. And it's cool because at its core, it's about learning about the relationship. And they give you certain questions that kind of, you know, that you kind of cringe at, like, oh man, I could never, you know, ask that question because I'd be scared to find out what the answer is. But if you can't answer those questions with the person that you're in a relationship with, then why are you in a relationship with that person? You know, like, you need to be vulnerable, like naked, you know.
And, but there's also on the site exes that have played the game.
Yes, that's also true too. Like that's the cool thing too. Like there's exes that have played this game, and they find out like why, what happened in their relationship, why didn't work out, why one of them cheated on the other and like didn't care or whatever. Like, and it's all walks of life, and it's so cool. Like you'll see like not high school sweethearts, but like you'll see like high school students like on their senior year about to go to college, and you know they're gonna go to their separate colleges, and what are they going to do? So they ask them these questions and stuff, and it's really awesome, and I fell in love with it. The video, there's like about like 40 videos at a time. They kind of rotate every week with new couples and like old classic like couples too, and they're like 4 to 5 minutes long. And the cool thing is they allowed you to, there's two ways that you can play the game, and it is either by the app, which is on
It's only on Apple products.
Yeah, it's on. Yeah, it's on. It's only iTunes. On Apple products, like iTunes. It's $1.99, but trust me, it's worth it. Or you can get how they do it on the videos is by ordering the cards. And when I saw that, I was like, oh my god, like I can play this. This is cool. So I'm like, yo, who the hell am I gonna play with this? Because I'm single. What the hell? Like I don't have no freaking thing. And I'm like, yo, maybe I can freaking talk to Jennifer about this because this would be really cool. And she was like, what's the and? And I'm like, yo, let me tell you about this. So like, so I told her about it and she was like, yo, let's do it. You know, so like.
I agree to it, but now.
Now she's scared.
I'm getting cold feet or maybe that's just a temperature.
Yeah, she's getting like super scared now. But like, yo, like this is.
Because I haven't really watched the videos yet because I wasn't mentally ready to. Yeah. And now that I am mentally ready to, I just haven't had the time.
Yeah, this is true too. Yeah, because like, yeah, she was like going through breakup. It was like the breakup. Beginning
of my breakup. And
like, and that's what that's what most of the videos were about, like breakups and like whys and stuff like that. So like she really couldn't like. I'm all like pressuring her, like watch it. This is so crazy.
She's like, ask your ex if he'll play with you. I'm like, ha, right. I think I asked. I think he said no.
Yeah. So like, yeah. She really couldn't do it. And so like she's never watched one video. I've watched like all of them.
And to be fair, I just opened the box like an hour ago.
Yeah. So. Yeah, she doesn't know what to expect. And like, I mean, I know what to expect, but at the same time, I don't know what questions will be asked of me, you know. So
are we going to play?
Yes, we are going to play. So this is going to be raw. This is all real. Like, this isn't scripted. We don't know what's on the cards or whatever. So, like, and we don't even know what we're going to say to each other. But I promise you that I'm going to keep it 100, as the kids say nowadays.
I'm gonna keep it real too because that's what I do. So let me just grab the box.
She's gonna grab the box and
so
she's
on
gonna
the back
read
of the box. It says how to play. Number yes. one, sit facing one another with a foot of distance between you. Me and Martina usually don't sit right next to each other, but because we knew we were gonna play this at some point today, he joins me over here on the couch. Number two, choose 12 random cards from the deck. We've done that. Well, we took a pile, so it was pick from the top.
Right.
Number three, take 30 seconds to relax and look at one another. We'll do that in a second. My heart's racing. Number four, one person begins by asking. Person two answers their question. Continue back and forth through all of the questions. Every question must be asked, but you do not have to answer the question. To earn the right to remain silent, you must look the person in the eye for 10 seconds before saying pass. Oh, I forgot about that part. Okay.
And don't worry, like, we'll, like, through the magic of editing, we'll speed it up. So, like, you don't have to just, like, sit there. Or maybe, like, it might, like, increase the suspense. Right. I don't know. We'll see.
All right.
Okay, so.
So we have to relax first.
Oh, okay.
So we don't put the cards in the middle?
Sure. Yeah. Put the cards in the middle, yeah. All
right.
Is this a foot?
Yeah. Like, okay. It's like it's a little more than a foot, but.
Okay, that's fine.
I mean, all right, hold on.
Oh, I was going to move closer. Okay, right. Okay, that's good.
All right.
Okay.
Relax,
right? Okay, relax. I need some yoga music or something. Just relax.
I'll put Deborah Cox on again.
No.
Okay, I'm relaxed.
Okay.
I'm good. Do you want to go first?
Okay, oh, so that's what it is. I got to go first. And
person one, person two.
Okay.
It doesn't say who. Just go first.
Right. So.
You're my guest.
I do it. And then.
I answer.
And you answer.
Right.
But I don't answer my own thing.
No.
Okay.
You just put the card down and we don't discuss it. We just keep going.
Okay.
It's not a discussion.
Are you ready?
As ready as I'm going to be.
Okay. Okay. Well, this is in present tense. So I will put it in past tense. Or you can put it in your head in past tense.
Okay.
What in our relationship are you most grateful for?
I would say present and past tense.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
I am most grateful for your honesty and your friendship. I am most grateful for the fact that... And I'm most grateful for your forgiveness. I definitely say that. Honesty, friendship, and forgiveness.
Nice.
My turn.
See, it's not so bad.
Shut up.
Yo, she's mad red right now.
My question.
Okay.
Do you really think we'll last?
Ooh. How do I even answer that?
Oh, well, no, yeah, well, oh, yeah. No, 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 we'll last because, again, I'm thinking romantically because of the videos. But do you think we'll last? Yeah, I believe so. The thing is, I mean, we do have a strong bond.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know if either you or I or the both of us have or get into a relationship with mm-hmm. our significant others, how they will accept that.
Right.
Because they'll be like, yo, what the F? I'm like, why are you always chilling with this dude? And they're like, oh my God, like you're chilling with Jennifer again? Like, what are you guys fucking? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, whoa, hey, whoa. You know what I'm saying? Right. Just doing a podcast. You know what I'm saying? So like, but I believe if we keep watering,
mm-hmm.
you know, the relationship and stuff like that, I think it'll be, yeah, I don't see why it wouldn't last.
Okay, your yeah. turn.
My turn? Okay. My turn. Oh, feeling your own question. Womp, womp. All right. That was a dud, guys. Sorry about that. All right. Let's do another one.
He too.
When you close your eyes and think of me, what do you see? Now, remember, people. She can pause. She can pass this question, but in order to do that, she has to look in my eyes for 10 seconds and say pass. So what do you want to do?
I don't know. When I close my eyes, what do I see?
Yes. When you close your eyes and think of me, darkness, what do you see?
Darkness.
What is this? Darkness. What do the five fingers say to the face? Slap.
When you close your eyes, what do you think of me?
What?
I just read it over. It's not like, what do I see? It's like, what do I think of you when I close my eyes?
No.
What?
When you close your eyes and think of me, what do you see? Oh. What the freak? Freaking dyslexic.
Sometimes.
Sorry for the people who are actually dyslexic. I'm not making fun of you. I'm sorry.
You're just making fun of me. I see comfort.
Mm.
That's more of a feeling, but I see it.
No.
You know how Kanye sees beats? That's what I say. Oh, you never saw that documentary?
No. Pharrell sees sounds.
Yeah, so it's like the same thing. I see comfort.
Mm-hmm.
So warmth and comfort.
Okay.
My turn.
Oh, wait. How many questions? Oh, crap. Was it four. Six each. No, but six each, right?
No, I think it's 12. Yeah, six each. Okay, this is four altogether.
Oh, okay. So two? All right.
Okay.
This was mine.
Name the top five things that you love about me.
Really? That's the question?
I'm not making it up. I'm not like on my like conceited shit. Teeny, what do you love about me?
Name five things that I love about you?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go from like, no, not superficial, but like, yeah. All right. I like your height.
Mm-hmm.
She's what, 4'11"?
4'11".
That's
yeah.
awesome. yeah, I like your height. Okay, so five things. Okay, I like your height. I like your good Samaritan like ways, because not a lot of people are like that. People are very cold nowadays, and totally understandably so. But like you're like, nah, you need a help, man. Yo, you need help? I'm here to help you. Here's my blanket. Here's my couch. Whatever. Like, I'm here to help you. You know, because that reminds me of me. And that, you know, and like, you're really good with that. Okay, so number three. Number three on the list of the five things that I like about Jennifer, that I love about Jennifer. Number three. You know what? I love that you gave me a chance all the way back then, because like, I really thought that like, you're like out of my league. Like, I was like, I'm not gonna freaking like, what? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, and this is gonna sound really funny, but funny on me, because I'm like, yo,
wow, a real girl. You know what I'm saying? Like not like a man, like, oh, I only play with mannequins. But but it's like, wow, you know, that's crazy. What was that, number three? So yeah, that was number three. So number one was height. Good Samaritan
gave you a chance.
Gave me a chance. Number four. I like Oh, what is that?
No, Jeopardy. No pressure.
Man, this is hard.
I don't know if you have to keep it PG or not.
No, it's whatever. Okay. But okay, so we'll go there. I do like your body. sometimes, let's say, like, she has to go to a party, or like she'll invite me to a party. Like, I remember a couple weeks ago, we talked about this on the podcast. We went to a party. I was going to say Super Bowl. I don't know. I forget what it was for. It was for a holiday or something like that. And she was looking all right. and I was like, yo, oh yeah, true. And it was another thing, too, where she had to go to this wedding. And I was like, yo, what's good?
Like, Jen grew up.
Yeah, I was like, yo, what's going
Thank
on?
Thank you, Martini. I'm pretty sure I'm super red right now, but go ahead. So number five.
Number five, hurry up. Number five. I like your eyes. I love your eyes, I should say.
Oh, thanks.
You have very nice eyes. They're kind of like goldily hazel in the right light.
Right. They change colors sometimes. They're weird.
Yeah. So I'm like, yo. Okay. But yeah.
Cool.
So there you go.
That was a deep question.
That was a deep question.
It's your turn.
Is it my turn?
Oh, yeah, because I just asked you.
Yeah. So wait. So where's the piles?
Oh, right here. Because,
okay. So
I had another card.
Question was mine? Okay. So, okay.
Go ahead.
All right. What do you want out of this relationship?
Everlasting friendship. Honesty. Mm-hmm. And just everlasting friendship. High five.
Okay.
Next question.
Why you get the easy questions?
Oh, this doesn't make sense. This is why did you choose to marry me?
Oh, okay.
We didn't go that route, Teeny.
No.
This is about marriage life. Jeesh. Okay. Fuck my life. Name the top five things you change about me.
Damn, okay. That's that was yours.
I know. Sorry.
The top five things that I would change about you.
See how deep this game is, people.
Yeah, it's deep, yo.
And you have to be honest.
Yeah.
Obviously.
Yeah.
I mean, we're kind of joking around for the sake of, like, you know, nerves and the viewers, but.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Top five things you change about me. Martini.
Top five things.
Oh, you know.
What? I know what? I don't know. I don't know. I don't know what that was. You want to help me out?
No, go ahead.
Top five things. Your short fuse. you do have a short fuse.
Uh-oh.
When she gets mad, like, yo, she will let you know, son. All right, she'll let you know that when she's mad. So maybe that. I'm not saying that you can't get angry. I'm just saying that the level and the quickness. You go 0 to 100
real quick.
All right. that's what happens. Says that. You self body shame. So you need to do more body positivity. See, like me, I like her body, but she does not. You know, and then like, you know, sometimes, you know, when I, you know, like I'll give her a hug, she'll like kind of cringe, whatever. She's like, nah, don't touch me. I'm like, yo, you have a great body. And just like, yo, let that rock. But you know, that's a barrier that you have to break.
Overcome.
And overcome. So anger, short fuse, and body positivity, that's what you need. Things that I'll change about you. I don't know. You need to change the dudes that you freaking are interested in. Like you need to change your type.
You're I don't know if you can change that. I mean, you probably can. But like, you need to be more aware of the type of men that you
are attracting.
That you're attracting, or that you're attracted to.
The crazy ones.
Because sometimes it gets you in a lot of trouble. And then you're like, I don't understand why it has to be this way. And it's like, well, I could have told you like 2 weeks ago. You know?
Okay.
There's that.
I can think of something that you always say.
Oh, please let me, yeah. That'll be my number four.
How you say that I don't let people do things for me?
Oh God, Jesus. Yeah, you're right. Like, make no mistake, Jennifer is a strong, independent woman, but capital I on the independent. She does not let anybody do anything for her. I don't know if it's because she was grown up that way, or people have dropped the ball, or a combination of both, but she does not let people do things for her. And I'm not saying that it needs to be like a big thing, whatever. Like, even picking something up on the floor, she's like, nah, I got it. He's just like, yo, I'm already here on the floor, I'll get it. You know? And then she's like, no, whatever. So she needs to be more lenient with people, and she needs to be, I don't want to say submissive, because that just has a negative connotation to it. But yeah, just a tad bit submissive.
What kind you like?
Oh God. I'm sorry if we offended anybody out there. No, but like,
I'm sorry, I was just quoting Coming to America.
No, oh, okay. Oh yeah, yeah, that's right. Yeah, we were just talking about that, weren't we?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, so yeah.
So five of the top five things that you would change about me. I'm getting my exes in here.
Hey, yo, can we go to 10? damn, I don't know. I really don't know. And I don't want to back out, too. I don't want to just go to 4, but what would I change about you?
Think hard, Martini. I can let you get away with 4.
Oh, no. I got it. Your openness. You need to be more open.
Wait, what?
In the bedroom. You've told me stories about things, and I'm like, yo. And you're like, no, I don't do that. I don't do this, and I never gonna do that. And I'm like, yo. And it's not like crazy things like, yo, you need to hang from the chandelier while I wear this clown mask. You know what I'm saying? It's not like crazy. It's not anything crazy like that. You know, but it's like,
I'll find a nice guy who doesn't like creepy things.
It's like semi kinky things, whatever. But like, it's just to not even spice up the mood, but just like, you know, just things in the arsenal. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, you just need to like open up and stuff like that. Now, I know you have rules, and I'm not saying that you need to break those rules, but like, I believe you should be more open sexually with your partners.
I'll let the next guy tell you how it goes.
Ew. But, okay, go ahead.
It's your turn to read to me. Oh,
yeah,
that's right.
Yeah. Well, it's going to be easy. Oh, what did you have for breakfast today? Like, it's going to be so freaking easy.
Nothing.
This is interesting, but I don't know how you
I'll make it work. Answer.
Do you think we should stay together?
Absolutely. Next question.
What? You see what I'm talking about? You see how deep I get? And then she's like,
No, I absolutely do think we should stay together and as friends, because I don't know. We keep gravitating back to each other. Well, I'm sorry. I gravitate to you, and you're like, bye, bitch. But I don't think there's any reason why we shouldn't ever like be in this courtship, because there's nothing for us to really fight about. You and I kind of have the same personality, and then when we get on our, like, we need space modes, we're like, how are you doing? Good. How are you? All right, well, we'll talk later. Bye. So
yeah,
and I think we kind of just know when the other person needs space, so
yeah,
I don't think there's any reason why we'd ever like brawl out again. So there's that. Next question.
What are the top 10 things? Like, whatever.
How do you feel we've grown apart?
How do you feel we've grown apart? Well, I mean, we did have that 7-year gap, and that was totally me and totally on purpose. and we just grew apart just because, we wanted different things. You know, you saw an opportunity to finally get back with your ex to make things work because you thought you had the formula, you know.
I have the formula. God, what it takes.
And then, you know, I was just like, but I don't matter, you know. And when I say that, it's not to be malicious, like you were malicious, whatever. You're like, nope, you don't matter. Peace. You know, it wasn't like that, but it was just like, you're like, but I can make it work with him, you know, and I just like bowed out.
Did I say that?
No. No. But it was more like that. You said something like that in a letter that you wrote to me.
Another time.
Yeah, but it was something like that. But yeah, I mean, that like that's how we definitely like grew apart. And like it's funny because like you said about like the whole gravitational thing. Cause like I was like, yo, like I'm never gonna speak to this chick again, and I told like the world about you, you know, my circle and stuff like that. Like, yo, this is so messed up, blah blah, all this stuff. But for some reason, like in the back of my head, like I kind of knew that I would eventually, be in contact with you like again. I didn't know was it to like, you know, whatever, like yell at you or whatever. But like I knew that wasn't gonna be the last of me seeing you because I did think about you like over the years. You know, whether it was fond memories or
negative
memories, it was always like a thing.
I know I'm not supposed to put like an aside, but I do find it amusing that our mutual friends, like, even though they know I was wrong, they still kind of like rooted for us to be friends again.
Right. Yeah.
They understood your side, but they were still kind of like, oh, that'd be nice. And now everyone's like, yay, you guys are friends again.
Yeah, and they were like so surprised because like, yeah, I didn't like tell anybody. I just told her. You know what I'm saying? and then, you know, she's like, you know, I guess she like told some of her friends like, oh, yeah, you know, guess what? You never believe it. Like, what? Like, I met Martini today. What? Oh, my God. You know, like, they're so crazy. So it was pretty funny. All
right, so your number five question.
All right, number five. No, wait. Oh, yeah, this is the number five question. Yeah,
you're number five.
No, I thought this was the last.
No, it's not. One more.
This is interesting too. I don't know, man. Let's see if you can work this out.
All right.
Does part of you feel like you're missing out by being with me for so long? You want to skip that? That's a damn good question for somebody in a relationship.
Yeah, it is.
You want to skip that one?
Yeah, because I don't really know how it applies to us.
Yeah, that's
that is a good question.
That's a damn. But you see what I'm talking about, people? That's a damn good question. Another easy ass question. How would you define our relationship?
We're not like brothers and sisters. That's creepy.
Ugh.
I don't know. We're like, I've told you and I've told others that you're my better half because you're a little nicer than I am, but you're like exactly like me.
Right.
Like, you get me, and that's cool. Mm-hmm. Like, if I do something, you're not like, why did you do that? You're like, oh, I know why you did it. So that's how I defined our relationship. Like, we're each other's, like, we balance each other, kind of.
Yeah.
So, and I appreciate that because everyone needs a little balance.
Yeah, definitely.
So, there's that. My turn.
Yep.
Moving right along. How have your feelings for me changed?
They've changed dramatically because
I fucking hated you.
I did, you know what I'm saying? I really did. But like, you know, once we met that day and we like really hashed it out and sometimes we still hash it out like till this day, you know, like there'll be like a little something and I'm like, oh, like remember that or whatever. And, you know, to really like hash it out and, you know, no, it's completely changed, you know, like. You know, like, I'll never forget, but, like, I have, like, forgiven you a while back, and, you know, and you're super cool, and like I said, you know, like, you'll say stuff, and I'm like, yo, like, that's how I would have thought of it, or, like, yeah, like you said, when you do things, and you're like, wow, I know exactly why you did that, because of X, Y, and Z, so it's really interesting, but yeah, it's changed dramatically for the better, for the positive.
Cool.
This is me?
Yep.
All right. Last question.
for you. His face looks intrigued but disappointed.
No, because I know you're gonna take the easy route with this.
I try not to.
Why don't you trust me?
Okay. I won't take the easy route. Mm-hmm. I don't trust you because you doubt yourself. Mm-hmm. And because you, as where I may body shame, you just...
Shame.
Thank you. And sometimes I feel like you withhold the best you because you're in that process. Mm-hmm. And that's why I don't trust you. Not that I don't trust you. I trust you with my safety and, like, to be honest with me.
Yeah.
But just as, like, in a general sense,
yeah.
That would be why. Did not take the easy route.
That's, wow. Less. And thank you for being honest. Thank you for that.
Do you trust me?
What the?
That's the question.
I know, but like, how did that come up like right after mine?
Apparently, we didn't shuffle good enough.
That's funny. What was it? Do I trust you?
Or do you want another question?
Do you trust me?
Actually, that's a fucking fabulous question, Martini.
Whoa. Why is that?
After everything that we've been through.
Yeah.
And my undecisiveness about everything.
Yeah.
Do you trust me?
Ooh.
No, seriously.
No, I'm thinking seriously. Okay. Do you trust me? That is a damn good question.
Oof. See, I thought it was gonna be easy.
No, it isn't. It isn't easy. Damn. I do hold reserve in the back of my head sometimes that you might revert to OJ. Like old Jennifer?
Oh, I was like...
like Simpson?
No, I was like...
And like... And not because of you, just because of maybe like circumstance and like you'll just like turn again. And I'm just like, are we really doing this again? You know, so like... I get nervous about that, only because I've just experienced it. You haven't really shown me any reason why you would do that, but you're still you, you know.
Did you hear the part that I've grown a lot?
Yes, you've grown a lot. Yes, no, but I mean.
No, I understand PTSD.
Yeah. What PTSD?
Post-traumatic stress disorder.
Oh, I know what that meant. I thought you were gonna like. Do like a modern spin on it or whatever, like
no.
Pretty whatever. No. I'm like, what?
I'm not that quick right now.
Yeah, so like, yes, same. It's definitely a hesitant,
yes,
you know, about trusting.
I respect
you.
That. We've only been friends now again for
6 months.
That's it, right?
6 months from a 7-year hiatus,
yeah.
So
yeah, I respect that. Let's do this again in 6 months.
Oh, okay. Maybe. Yeah.
Maybe your answers will change.
Yeah.
Maybe we won't know each other. Who knows?
But now, Bed Love Beyond with Jennifer.
Be like, what up, people? Sorry, kick Martini to the curb.
He was whack.
So that was fun. That was really interesting.
Oh, that was it?
Yeah, we're done, man.
Oh,
it wasn't as bad as I thought.
Okay.
But I like looked through some of the questions and I definitely see like where the issues lie.
Yeah, but I'm letting everybody know right now. I'm telling you, man, guys, you go to the site and there's gonna be more diesel questions and stuff like that. Like, I really want you to go. All right. So the website is www.theand.us theand.us. So go to that. Are you searching for the
meme? Yeah.
All right. So
our servers are kind of down. So
yeah, it's kind of weird.
A second.
Yeah. So I'll just explain what you do. So if you're, you know, first listening to us, hi, how are you? How you doing? I hope you listen to the old shows and more new shows that will be coming on. So what we do right now, the segment when we're, you know, we're closing down the show, is the meme of the day, because me and Jennifer and I love memes. And so Jennifer picks out a meme that kind of, sometimes it goes with the subject matter of the episode, and sometimes she just finds something really hilarious. And she reads the meme, and we discuss what it means to us, what the meme means to us. So, Jennifer, have you found something yet?
Yeah, I have to pick a new one because their servers are down. Oh, but crap. So I'm going to pick this one really quick. It's from some e-cards. Mm-hmm. Or actually, this one's from www.cambio.com. I'm not sure what that's about. It says, sorry, I'm not Adele. I don't wish the best for you. And nor do I want to find someone like you. However, I would like to set fire to all of your stuff.
So if you don't know what that's referencing, that's, wait, isn't that two songs in one?
That's like a whole slew of songs that you probably hate.
No, all right, so I don't wish the best for you. So, oh yeah, so never mind, I find someone like you. That, so mm-hmm. That's someone like you, and then set fire to the rain.
Yeah.
Right? Okay. From the same album, right?
Yes.
19,
yeah.
No, 21. Yeah, 21. 21?
19 is the album that did you in, Martini.
Yes, it did. Ugh, freaking. Anyway, so, yeah, sometimes, you know, you feel that way, you know, about, like, your ex. Just like, yo, I don't want you freaking being good or, like, being better than me. Like, F you. You're the one who left me, or you're the one who did me wrong. How are you going to...
We always say we don't want to find someone like our ex, but we always end up finding someone like him.
You know what? Not meme, but you know what? Track kind of sounds like this. I forget what song it is from Kelly, from who it is, but Kelly Clarkson, and the line goes, "I will never wish bad things, but I don't wish you well." Mm. And I was just like, "Damn." I was like, yo, I like that. Because, you know, you don't want to be malicious, but, like, you don't want that person, like, you know, skip to Malou all happy and stuff. Like, nah, I want you to feel what you did to me. But, you know, you can still get yourself, but no, you don't deserve to be happy. So I'm like, wow, that's
fire.
That's pretty deep.
Well, I don't know. Is that it, Martini? Are we wrapping up?
Oh, that's it. We're wrapping up. But next, our next podcast has to deal with preferences and types. So, I mean, that was pretty funny how that came up on the one of the Anne's postcards about, you know, trying not to fall into the same type, you know, because that's not good, because, you know, you want to evolve every time you go to a new person. So, yeah, that's going to be on the next podcast about, you know, preferences and types. Like, why do we like the types that we do? Like, do we have a certain type, and then and all that stuff, or, and like, how do we do to, you know, combat that, or just, you know, let the cards fall where they may? But anyway, thank you for listening.
Thank you. It was enlightening.
Yeah, it was definitely enlightening. You know, so Bed Love Beyond, please listen to us all the time. Tell your friends, all that stuff. So I guess that's it, right?
That's it. We're wrapping up.
All right, cool. So thanks, everybody. You guys have a good day.
Peace.